President Biden is taking on climate change as part of his new infrastructure plan. The bill would allocate billions of dollars to turn our economy greener. And here are some of the big ones. The plan would give $100 billion to the country's electrical grid that would help build new power lines that can help transfer power over long distances. The plan gives $174 billion for electric vehicles. This would come as tax incentives for Americans who buy electric cars. And the money would also help build more EV chargers. And $400 million to promote clean energy. It would offer incentives to anyone installing new clean power that includes homeowners and companies. And joining us now to discuss all of this is Zeke Hausfather. He is a climate scientist from the Breakthrough Institute. And Zeke, thanks so much for joining us. It's so nice to see your face. I just named three ways this plan would combat climate change. Let's start with the money that would go to our electrical grid. Zeke, how would that help
us? So our electrical grid is in dire need of repair and maintenance. You know, most of the grid was built in the 1940s and 1950s, and it was a design for a very different world than we have today. It was designed for a world where we had big coal-fired power plants outside of cities that could send power into those cities. But the world that we're envisioning to move away from fossil fuels is one where there's a lot more small-scale wind power, solar power. You know, you're producing power where the wind is blowing and when the sun is shining. And to do that effectively, you need to be able to send power over much longer distances. So the wind might be best in Iowa, but there's not that many people who live in Iowa. So being able to send that energy to Chicago, to St. Louis, or even all the way to the East Coast is really, really helpful. And so for a long time, people have thought that if we can build a 21st century grid, we can really support a 21st century energy system. And this is, you know, the Biden administration really recognizing that fact and putting some serious money behind it.
Okay, $174 billion, Zeke, to electric vehicles. What is that money for, like rebates and stuff?
So a good portion of it would go to rebates and tax incentives for Americans to buy American-made electric vehicles. But a fair bit would also go to incentives for EV charger deployment to make sure that when you're driving an electric vehicle, you are never going to be in a situation where you run out of gas, so to speak, or run out of electricity on the road, that there'll be enough charging stations to make it so you can easily go from one side of the country to another. And transportation is the single largest contributor to our emissions in the U.S. And so switching to electric vehicles is really a key technology to help get us to reducing emissions in that sector. It also has money to electrify about 20% of the U.S. school buses. And 100% of the U.S. federal fleet. So all federal vehicles will be ultimately electric.
Oh, that's good. And the rebates are definitely incentive. I know when they were like in full force in California, a lot of people bought electric cars because they could get up to $10,000. So that is a huge incentive. Okay, what about funding for clean energy subsidies, $400 million? Specifically, what would that go toward?
So $400 billion with the B. And that would go toward giving clean energy sources like wind and solar an advantage over dirty energy sources like coal and natural gas. So today, federal subsidies cut about one-third off the cost of wind and solar. But that program, you know, is continued for short periods of time. It sort of comes in fits and starts. And that uncertainty makes it really hard for people to plan for long-term power projects. And so what this would do is essentially make those subsidies permanent and also make it easier for companies to get them. Because right now, they're just tax incentives. And so if a company doesn't have a big enough tax bill, it's hard for them to claim that incentive. And so this would transfer more of them into direct payments to companies. So make it a lot easier to install solar and wind.
Zeke, do you think this goes far enough? Are you happy with this plan? Or what else, if there are some holes, what would you like to see?
So I'm pretty happy with this plan. If it passes, it will definitely be by far the biggest climate bill that has ever passed in the United States. And in addition to what we talked about, it has a lot of money for, you know, more advanced research and development into things like advanced nuclear power, into things like carbon capture and storage, enhanced geothermal, battery storage. There's a lot of other technologies that this bill also invests in. And so, you know, it's pretty comprehensive. And to be honest, it is more than a lot of us were expecting.
Okay, Zeke Hausfather from the Breakthrough Institute, thanks so much for your insight and your time, and hope to speak to you again soon. Thanks so much.
Thank you.